Hey everyone, this is Kirkacola, and in today's video, I will explain everything you need to do to set yourself up for a successful Raft gameplay. This video is meant for brand new players and will cover what you need to do in the very early game. The topics that I'm going to go over are all of the basic controls, how to craft items, crafting prioritization, resource gathering tips, dealing with the shark, building your raft and item placement, island encounters, becoming 100% sustainable, and beginning the main story. These are all of my tips and tricks that I've compiled over my multiple playthroughs. Remember that Raft is a survival game, so making sure you actually have the resources to survive is crucial, and it's why watching this video is so important. If you want to see more of this type of content, please make sure to interact by subscribing, liking, or commenting on this video. Any bit of interaction will go a long way. Without further ado, let's load up into a game and start. Raft is an open-world survival game where you gather resources, upgrade your raft, and explore islands in search of finding the rest of civilization. It has been one of my favorite games so far, and I wanted to share some of my tips and tricks to help you have a successful game. Controls. Here are the basic controls. On your raft or on land, use WASD to move, space to jump, control to crouch, and shift to run. While in the water, use WASD to move, space to swim up, control to swim down. Press tab to open up your inventory and crafting. Left click to use items, eat food, or place things. While looking at a placed item, hold X to remove it and return it to your inventory. Press E to interact with different items. You can use the number keys to quickly gain access to your inventory, and press Q to discard your held item. Press T to look at the journal when you need coordinates. Crafting. Out of all of the survival crafting games I've played, Raft has one of the easiest crafting experiences. Press tab to access the inventory and the crafting menu. In the middle of the screen, you will see your inventory, and on the left is the crafting menu. Click the category of the item you want to build, and then click the item to find its specific recipe. I will go over all of the essential items that you need to craft in the next section. Here's a quick tip. If one of the materials needed can be crafted, you can hover over that item in the recipe. It will turn into a green plus sign. Left click and it will make one for you automatically. This is a super helpful tip that will save you loads of time. Essential items. When you first drop in, you will find yourself on a 2x2 raft with just a plastic hook in hand. On the bottom left of the screen is your health, food, and water bars. If any of these fall under the threshold, you will have decreased mobility and vision. Take a look around and you will eventually find the shark, who will continuously try to attack you and your raft. Since Raft is first and foremost a survival game, in this tutorial we're going to be strictly focusing on surviving. By the end of your first hour or two, you should have adequate food, water, and resources to help you get through the game. Here is a list of all of the early game items in order of when you should build them. I made a convenient chart so you can reference it as you play. This is probably the most important part of the video, so take some time to study this list. Essential, build ASAP. You want to build these items as soon as you can. The wooden spear, building hammer, simple purifier, empty cup, small crop plot, simple grill. These next items are needed to continue your journey, but not right away. The paddle, stone axe, small storage, and research table. After you've built all of those, you can start to build the collection net. Lastly, these items are not necessarily needed, but can help make your gameplay a little more smooth. Simple bed, throwable anchor, and the wooden fishing rod. Resource gathering tips. With a hook in hand, hold left click to charge it up. Remember to aim slightly up and in front of the items you want to gather. Once the hook is in the water, hold left click again to reel it in. If you happen to miss, you can reel in the hook immediately by pressing right click. This will only work if your hook didn't catch anything. If any resources float next to your raft, you can pick them up by looking at it and pressing E. You can even do this while reeling in items with the hook. Dealing with the shark. Every 5 minutes, the shark will start biting your raft. Hit it with your spear 3 times and it will go away. If you're too slow, the shark will destroy a piece of your raft, as well as any items that were on it. After the shark goes away, you want to pull out your building hammer and repair the panel back to 100%. To see a fully detailed explanation on how to kill the shark, check out the video on my channel. Building your raft and item placement. When you have enough resources, build your raft outwards and start placing your essential items in the center. Building in the center will ensure that you can move easily around your raft, and it will also make it harder for the shark to destroy any of your hard work. First, we're going to make sure that we have a reliable source of food and water. To achieve this, we will make a small crop plot, simple water purifier, and simple grill. The small crop plot grows up to 3 vegetables, potatoes or beets, at a time, and cooking those vegetables with the simple grill will give us extra energy. Simple water purifier will be able to use to hydrate ourselves and water the plants. This will be enough to get us by. Eventually, we're going to build 2 of each of these, so we can guarantee we have enough resources and focus on upgrading our raft. Both the simple water purifier and the simple grill need wood planks to work. Make sure that you have enough in your inventory and use the hook to grab some out of the water. A great way to get more wood is stopping at an island, which you will eventually come across on your journey. Island encounters. Lucky for us, a great way to find wood, palm leaves, food, and other essential early game resources like scrap and rock is at an island encounter. It's pretty random when you will see an island, but eventually you will come across one in the distance. Your raft probably won't be headed straight towards it, so you will likely need to use a paddle to travel there. If your raft is small enough, you might be able to get it stuck on the shore. You can also use a throwable anchor to position your raft nearby. When you're on the island, take out your stone axe and chop down any palm or mango trees that you find. This will give you a lot of wood and leaves, as well as some food. You may also find watermelons or pineapples on the ground. You can pick those up, but discard the seeds that come with them. You won't be able to use those for a while. If you find flowers, just skip them for now. They're used for decorations later in the game, and they're not essential for survival. Under the water near an island, there is a small ecosystem with gatherable items. You will use a hook to pick most of these up, but be very careful doing so since the shark will attack you. In the early game, prioritize picking up scrap and stone since they are super helpful getting your raft started. If you have space and can do so safely, also try to get metal ore, dirt, sand, copper ore, and seaweed. Becoming 100% sustainable. Once you have a comfortable supply of food, water, and wood, build a research table so you can start unlocking new crafting recipes. Simply drag a resource such as wood, plastic, rope, or scrap onto the research table and hit research. Doing this will unlock recipes that use that resource. Some recipes require you to research multiple resources. The main item that you want to create that will really speed up your game is the collection net. The collection net is placed on your raft and will automatically catch up to 10 resources that pass through it. Building enough of these will give you a passive and steady income of wood, plastic, palm leaves, and crates. In order to unlock it, you need to research the planks, rope, and nails. To place, walk onto an open section of the raft and place it down. The collection net functions similar to a foundation panel since you can walk on it, but remember that the shark can also attack it. To prevent this, you can build metal foundations on them that are unlocked later in the game, or you can simply build an additional foundation around it. Beginning the main story. If you follow this guide, you will have a very stable supply of food, water, and resources. Now you're ready to get started on the main story, starting with building your antennas and receiver. I will cover how to get started with all of this in the next video, but for now, I wanted to thank you for watching. I hope you learned something and wish you the best of journeys on your raft. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave a like and subscribe while you're at it. If you want me to cover any other topics, feel free to comment or message me on Discord.